Okay. And another question many people may ask, might ask that suppose somebody's Venus is sitting, or not Venus, I would say, suppose Jupiter is sitting somewhere and Saturn is also sitting there. They are conjunct. Okay.
Yeah.
So now, does it happen that when Jupiter, because Jupiter gets activated quite earlier than Saturn, so does it
Will
happen?
get the support of Saturn. It will get that support of Saturn. Why just sitting? Why just sitting? So this was your question. So what will Saturn do, right?
Oh,
now,
yeah. My question was that does it happen that when Jupiter gets active, Saturn also gets active, or Jupiter will not be
Saturn is
active till
supporting you.
36 like Saturn?
Saturn is supporting you. Saturn is supporting you all the way.
Okay.
So what happens is, say, like, I'll tell you, I'll show you the chart. Very good question that you asked. I'll show you the chart. Okay. So, okay. Now, Mars. Okay. So when we're talking about Mars, I jumped the gun for you on this question. When we're talking about Mars, we're talking about Marilyn Monroe. So Marilyn Monroe's chart, Jupiter and Mars are sitting together.
Okay.
Now, we know that Mars gets activated at 28. Okay. I could have taken her chart again, as I said, I could have taken her chart for Jupiter also. Do you know at 16 years of age, Marilyn Monroe was married?
Okay.
And what is Jupiter? Jupiter is her, and it was under a compulsion. Had she not been married at that time, she would have to go back to an orphanage. Because of her parents, not her foster parents, parents, adoptive parents, were moving out of state, and that state did not allow the adoptive child to move. So the only thing was that on her birthday, at 16th birthday, just a few days or after her 16th birthday, she was married. Okay, and so now you can ask me a question that how will Mars support her there? Now, because Mars is not active at that time, but Mars is with Jupiter. So what does, now Mars, this is also happening in the 8th house. 8th house is also about sexual pleasures. So that is the time, it's also the 9th lord, Jupiter, of what? Of marriage, of legality of marriage. Where she was legally married before she went into a relationship with her husband.
Okay, so basically you are saying if two planets are conjunct and both are active at different ages, so then the planet which gets activated earlier will get activated, and the other one who is getting activated later will support this activation.
Yes, it will support. See, it's
okay.
Like, okay, now I'll give you an example. It's like, I am mature, okay. In India, the legal age of drinking is 21. Supposing a child gets, now there's this guy who gets, who is now waiting for 21. Today, the generation wants to go and experiment with the alcohol. So, you are not allowed, you will not be served alcohol in pubs or anywhere if you are not 21 years of age. So now it's his 21st birthday, and he decides that now I can buy alcohol, get it at home. He also gets permission from his parents. So he has a younger brother. Okay. So the younger brother, he says that, look, I will not serve it to you, but you can help me with my friends. He can be there in the party. So the younger brother can be an assistant there, may not be allowed to drink. I've used a very crude example, but then that is an example where you understand that yes, you can't do certain things. You may not have been mature enough to be a very strong planet there working, but you aided that event. In conjunction, it could also be in it can also just, you know, it could be an aspect. Rahu is aspecting that. So it was her karmic destiny. Rahu gets matured at 42. So she's not going to wait till 42 before she has a relationship. Does she? Will she? Rahu was aiding that. That was a karmic destiny for her to get married.
Okay, and one more question I was thinking to ask. So now suppose Mars gets active in this chart at 28.
Right.
So Mars is in Aquarius. So it is like saying the house of Saturn is active.
See, you are taking it, I wanted to keep it very simple, but you are taking it to a very different level. Yes.
Okay.
And I don't mind answering so that, you know, there are layers. This, again, as I said, there are layers to it. Mm-hmm. So the eighth house of, it's Saturn. Where is Saturn sitting? You also, there's a book by Jane Basine, which goes by the dispositors. Okay, it's a book on dispositors. So who's the dispositor of Jupiter and Mars? As you said, it's Aquarius, so it's Saturn. Saturn, where is it? It's sitting in the fourth house of family. Your home, your security.
Yes, I mean, it will always have, you know, like now Venus will aspect.
Oh, yeah, it's a very fine web. It's a very fine web. That is why.
That's how life is, after all.
Yes. So there are very many layers to it. You begin with the first layer, and I'm happy you've asked me these questions. So people know that how to transcend each layer. You first see where's Mars placed again. So you see where Jupiter is placed. Then you see Mars is aiding it. Then you see, is Saturn doing any work? Because Saturn is the dispositor of Mars. You see which year they are working and which years. Later on, we also have a activation years, you know, the series of years that are activated. It's not just Jupiter. You think Jupiter just acts at 16 and stops its activity. So you can't learn after 16. You can't go in for higher knowledge. Or you can't get recognition. There's another, it's maturing at that age. It's showing a very important event in your life at that age. After that, it will start gradually having a series of years that you're doing progression.
Amazing. It's like very snapshot, you know when I can see the fruits, as you said, of the planets.
Yes. It is.
Yeah, we can use this like this also. Now, so for example, like in this case, seventh lord is Saturn.
Yeah.
So something to do with marriage or, you know,
partnership
again happen at 36, or she could see something manifesting externally.
Yes. Why not?
Like,
I can just take one chart and I can show you all of it.
Yes.
I can just take one chart and I can show the entire thing. But I wanted to give people a flavor of things that were different to, you know, don't mix and match everything.
Yes.
See individually and then you can, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So Rajesh Khanna at the age of 22. So if your son is maturing at 22 in the fourth house, okay, of the masses, there must be something that will create a hype for him on an international level, because Sun is the ruler of the 12th house also, international level. So he, it's like if you add a 42 plus 22, you will get 60, you will get the age of 64. Okay. And that is just beyond that, we've seen that, you know, he had, just a few months after that, he had won the contest, All India contest. Again, as I tell you, he had, during that time, why did I take up 43? Because it is 29th of December. So I have to move it merely 1 or 2 days there. So it is 43 to 45. And in 1965, he had won that All India contest for you organized by the United Producers and Film Fair, and as a result, he was chosen. He won that, and he became an actor. He got movies to act in. He became an actor. He became a superstar. So that was a turning point. The sun gives him a turning point. That is just a turning point, Bhavjit. Again, I'm telling you, a maturation age is just a turning point. From then, you can either go any which ways, turn any which ways, and it will just simply start giving its energy loudly and clearly.
Amazing, very interesting.
Okay, so let's move on to the next. Mobility and change. Arnold Schwarzenegger. Now, Arnold Schwarzenegger, since he was 10 years of age, he had realized that he wanted to go to US, and he had also set his mind on going to US as a bodybuilder. So when you add the ages, you will see in 1970, okay, nearly 23 plus, that is, he was in his 24th year. And he captured his first Mr. Olympia title in New York, and he went on to win the title of total 7 times. Okay, so you understand that this moon is showing a change in him. It is the second lord of his education, his moral ethics and everything, which is showing somewhere his hard work, and that is showing somewhere in the 7th house. What is the 7th house? The 7th house is partnerships. The 7th house is public life. But 7th house is also a platform. When you move out from the first 6 houses, which are totally yours, and you move out to a bigger platform, and that is the 7th house, the public platform. So he gets a public platform after working real hard at the age of 24. Okay. So we've done Marilyn Monroe, but we've done it with Jupiter for her. So I'll do it with Mars with her. In September 1954, that if you add it, you will get it to be a 28th running for her. So she began filming the 7-year itch, and for that she grossed a $4.5 million at the box office. And we're not talking about today 4.5 million. So today, in today's day and time, 4.5 million doesn't even bring about a ping in the meter. But we're talking about 1955. We are talking about more than 60 years ago. So she literally, that movie literally grossed a huge amount for her. Okay. And again, if you see, Saturn is placed in the 4th house again of the masses. So every house will have a number of factors associated with it, number of karakas, karakatvas. Every planet stands for a number of karakas. That movie, if any of you have seen that movie, 7-Year Itch, it is all about fantasies. About a married neighbor having sexual fantasy about his very young girl staying next door. So you see, the 8th house is also about all those things. The 8th house is operating. Mars is also about all those things. Mars is also passion, because Mars is the 8th lord of the natural zodiac. It's the energy. And it's in the 8th house, it's very strong. Now, if you wanted me to add on the nakshatras with it, it is in the Purva Bhadra nakshatra. Purva Bhadra nakshatra shows a very intense energy. It's a very intense energy. And it's very energetic a nakshatra, which is more to do with nervous tension, which is more to do with trepidation, which is more to do with maintaining a double face, a personality within a personality. So all these things, you can see that they are just so much resonating in this movie also, and in her chart. Now we'll be talking about Atal Bihari Vajpayee Ji. So in 1957, in the Indian general election, he he had contested, and that was his 32nd year. Okay. And he was a dynamic young man at that age. So he had contested elections to the Lok Sabha, the lower house of Indian Parliament, and was elected from Balrampur. And during that time, his oratory skills were so impressive that Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru at that time said that Vajpayee Ji would someday become the Prime Minister of India. And he was the first Prime Minister to break the Congress monopoly for so many years when he became the Prime Minister, which in itself was a huge phenomenal task. So we have, and now you can check out the years about his chart, which were more important. But then we need to see which planet is also very, very strong in a person's chart. So we would be able to say that yes, that particular planet will without fail show a very strong impression during its year of maturity. Okay. Now, when we're talking about Vishwanathan Anand, okay, so Vishwanathan Anand, in the year when he was 16 years, he became the national chess champion. But apart from that, okay, and he became a very strong contender right from the age 16 to even now. He does a lot of work for chess in India. So even now he's a big shot with so many people turning up on that radar also, but he's still the name that is taken, you know. But one very beautiful thing is when he says my best games of chess, that was about that very period, you know. That was about that very period that he had taken into account. And these games were taken very much into account during that time. Frank Sinatra. So, you know, this is very beautiful. At the age of 25, he made his first public appearance. Okay, and Dorsey, who was kind of his, mentor or kind of his friend, mentor, anything that you say, Dorsey said that, you know, you could feel the excitement of the public when he was just a very skinny kid. But when he stood up to sing, people were kind of falling to look at him. And again, as I said, third house is also about orator, not just an orator, it's also about singing. If you have good vocal cords, you should bless your third house for that. And they said that, you know, people used to be so amazed that, you know, a kid can do so much, can have such a pull for the crowd. There are times, he said, Dorsey said, and when Dorsey was extremely very, very particular about his own music, he said, I almost forgot to take my own solos. So finally, we come to Saturn, yes. So the Macho Man also has a Saturn to his, But I do not want to talk on that. I want to talk on the chart of our president, congressional president, that is JFK. And his chart says that he was elected to the U.S. Senate and served as the junior senator from Massachusetts from 1953 to 1960. And that is when Saturn, 1953, 36 years of age, that is when Saturn is kind of vibrating at its full potency for him. And that is, again, you see, the sixth lord of competition in the 11th house of games. You are a junior senator at that age. Senator. So that's a high gain in life. Fifth house of celebrityhood. The Kennedys were always in news. So you can see how it's working. You see, it's also aspected by Mars from the 8th house. Mars is also the third lord of oratorship. He had great skills as an orator. So now if you want me to give you another set of ages, if you want me, I will be more than happy to give it to you. So moon is effective. You know, a childlike phase, mobility, you see a lot of growth in a child, right? A lot of changes in the way a child walks. There's a lot of change and mobility in a child's life from 0 to 4 years of age. That is the time when it is ruled by moon. Your skills of learning, of speaking, of expressing yourself, be it all your educational skills, are developed during the next 10 years. That is from 4 years to 14 years. That is ruled by Mercury. Again, you can see that, see, this is a layer of, again, I can tell you that 4 years, you divide it by 12 and see how it's working out in your chart. A lot of things I can tell you, but here I'll keep it simple. You will also see that how does Venus become strong. So when you are dealing with a child, you have to know that these are the moon years for a child. So as much as a child learns in terms of being mobile, in terms of going to school, making friends, changing, adopting to changes properly, then that becomes active for a person. Mercury, that is the time when a child should be given total attention in terms of studying, learning, because post that is the time of Venus. That 8 years is the time of Venus, when the child will show hormonal growth, they will start to have more interest in fine arts, the child will have a recognition of the opposite gender. So all these things will play up in the child's life. Then comes the time of the sun, the 19 years, when you have to work, when you have to shine in life, you have to show that I can do a good job for myself, wherever I'm sitting. Mars is again the 15 years, the next 15 years is ruled by Mars. When you are totally geared up, you're very focused, you put in a lot of energy in whatever work you do because you want to be the best, you are the general, you plan, you execute, you try to gain in your share of the work, all those things. And finally, when you're moving from your 50s to your 60s, you gain a lot of insight and wisdom about life. And people come to you, people talk to you, people ask your advice because you have a wealth of experience of life. And you know how to be better with it. By the time Saturn sets in, we are an old people, we are set in our ways, our life is very determined and all those things. So it's all about the seven planets and their attributes.
That is all.
You want more?
You can go on and on.
Okay, thank you so much. Next time, probably, I will.
Thank you so much. And I forgot to say in the beginning that she also has an amazing YouTube channel. Of course, everybody knows, but just if somebody doesn't know, then I will pin the channel down in the description section. And you also do readings. And I will also give your website down. So if you are interested to know how and when and to what extent when these planets will ripen and they will show their effects, then you can approach her, you can go to her website and you can ask her that I saw this in your video, now please tell it how it will affect me.
Yeah. And Bhajit, we also have a course on D10 coming up, that is the Shamsha, for your career with Mr. VP Goel. It's specifically in English and to Hindi. We have two different segments. So if anybody is interested, we also are giving a book along with the course on D10.
Wow, that's majestic.
Thank you.
So when is that course exactly?
That course is on 2nd and 3rd of November It's a two and a half hour session each, where sir goes in depth about your career and tells you a lot about the D10 chart. And you can, at the end, every day there will be a half an hour question answer round also. So it's a beautiful course coming up, because he's one of the amazing teachers who keeps it simple and short.
Oh.
And gives in a lot of knowledge in just his one-liners.
Okay, nice. So whoever is interested to know about your career specifically from the Dasam Sir chart, you can watch the, and you've done some videos also with VP Sir, right?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, you can watch the videos, and if you want more knowledge, then please go and join the course or webinar, whatever it is. And
that's easy. 2-day course. It's not a very long course. It's just a 2-day course.
Okay. And where can they register for the course?
That's available on the website.
Okay, so please go to her website and there you'll find all the details. Okay. Anything else you would like to say?
I'd like to say thank you, and I hope that all the planets shine better and they give us a good result wherever they sit in our charts.
Yes, that will always happen. All right. Thank you so much for your time and for coming, and hope to see you soon again.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Bye.